We have Seema Doshi with us today. She's a franchise partner in Gujarat and she's been with us for a while. Who's going to be sharing with us her experiences and her thoughts in terms of how the recruitment industry is and the opportunities which it has. Seema, welcome.
Hi.
Seema, could you share with us first in terms of what was your prior experience before becoming a franchise partner of Talent Corner?
Definitely. I completed my graduation in BSc Mathematics and did a 1-year diploma course in computer application. That is my educational background. And my initially I started my career in recruitment firm, only a family-owned recruitment firm. I worked there for 2 years around, handled big clients, corporate clients like Alstom, Atul Industries, Trident Groups, manufacturing industries mostly you can see, for 2 years. Then I switched my career to Nielsen, one of the leading company in market research domain in the world. Then I was in a project which was taken over by the TCS, Tata Consultancies, and then I became a member of Tata Group, TCS, and I served there for 12 years almost in a different roles, different profiles. And when I left that company to join Talent Corner as a partner, I was there designated as an assistant manager. Okay. So that was my background before coming to the Talent Corner.
So, Seema, 12 years in the corporate industry.
One of the leading
corporate industries like TCS. Mm-hmm. What was the reason of choosing recruitment as a career option?
Well, everything was going smooth because, you know, I joined TCS and my career graph was there, almost on a growing curve was there. Everything was going smooth. Life was, settled with whatever projects or role profiles I was doing there. But I observed that there are a lot of opportunities in around the world. Okay. So I should not stuck only in one role, one profile, in one company, however big it is. I should grow. So I started looking for what I can do, where I can move with my career further. So I decided to move, whether should I go with my own company or I should go with something like partnering with some firm to get success in the new ventures. So meanwhile, we connected with Snehal, a franchisee developer in Talent Corner. So we had a small conversation with her. Then we met Rashesh Doshi and we come to know about the franchisee model. And somewhere I started my career as a recruiter. So that soft feeling was always there. In this field, I can have a calculated risk. So, and I liked this franchisee model. Because everything was crystal clear. Whatever was explained to us was crystal clear. What is model, how it operates, whatever the partnership ratio, whatever things were there, were very much clear. So we said, okay, I have some experience paired to this recruitment and I can develop again in that. So this was the comfortable where I can take risk, leaving a very reputed job from TCS and then again start something my own.
Okay.
That's the reason to start with the recruitment.
Great. And when we started off with the franchise, one of the things that we do is we provide training to all the franchise partners. What was your experience with the training? Anything that you'd like to share?
Definitely. Having so much professional experience. But when we start something new, you should go with some training initially, because you may be experienced in your field, but if you are starting like recruitment, where I have not any touch at that time, so it's good to have some training. And thankfully, Talent Corner has provided us 2-day full training. Snehal herself have given us the training, 2-day full training, and that was very useful. We started with how to search in the portals, what kind of job descriptions are there, how we can judge or we can find the keywords and all that kind of stuff was already trained on that. So that was a very good training provided by the Tenant Corner in the initial phase, where I groomed myself again, refreshed my knowledge with the other experiences. That is very much important, because if you don't learn the new age technologies criteria, you cannot succeed, you cannot search.
Perfect. And is the training provided to you continuously? Because one of the things that Talent Corner promises is to do continuous online trainings. Have you been a part of continuous online trainings?
Yes, there have been a lot of videos shared. So still I am looking those videos as well. Already I have looked at, but to just get refreshed all the time, so we don't miss anything in our process. So online trainings are also there, which is really very much helpful.
Right. Also, you know, when one starts with a franchise, they expect the main company, the head office, to provide continuous support in terms of big and small things. Could you elaborate in terms of, has that support been provided, and what kind of support does Talent Corner as a brand provide to its franchises?
Well, I have got all the support in terms of administration as well, because one of the team leader from the head office is assigned to my office. She continuously support us, Joyita her name. She continuously support me on getting the new requirement. If I'm having any, I'm stuck somewhere with the client or HR, so any problem is there, payment follow-ups, everything she is taking care from my side, so I can concentrate on recruitment part more.
Right. You mentioned about you know, the team leader giving you requirements. Again, one of the USPs of Talent Corner is to provide the franchisees enough work and good quality work on a continuous basis. Do you think you've been provided good quality work on a continuous basis?
Yes, definitely.
Are you kept very busy at all points of time?
A lot of work is there. It's like you have to just ask, I want a new company or new position or something. She will be there in the next 4 hours giving you another position, another company. So there are a lot of work. There is no question about that. It's like, it's up to us how much we can do.
Great. Seema, one of your biggest strengths has been the ability to build relationships, right? And we keep harping on this fact that recruitment business is all about building strong relationship, you know, with your clients. Can you share with us as to what do you do to build relationships and how has it benefited you?
Well, Tajput, the relationship with my clients, HR, has been always good. So that's a plus point, and this is a very important thing in recruitment business, because when we are in direct contact with the HR, if we are not directly connected with them, good relationship rapport is not there, we are not going to get a good business with them, good closures with them. So that is a very much important thing. Mostly I try to keep contact, whether position is there or not, try to keep contact in 7 days or 15 days time period with the client. Whether they are giving position or not is a different thing, but just having a word good morning with them, I'll try to keep them call. That's the key point.
Great. So saying a good morning regularly is really helping you build relationship with them. Fantastic. That's a good input. Also wanted to check with you, Seema, what do you think are the challenges that are there in this business? Now I understand that every business has opportunities and challenges. And we don't want to make this business sound like, you know, a brilliant business without any challenges. But if you were to identify 2 or 3 top challenges, what according to you are those that are there which person needs to be aware about?
Challenges, first thing is the competition. Okay. There are a lot of competition. As we are recruiting, there are many other recruiters as well. May not be giving the quality work as we are giving, but they are in the market. So the competition is one of the threat we always have. So, and the second is the OPEX, whatever operation expenditures we are having as a franchisee. So one should be aware of that and should have a stable team, operational team. So that should be calculated in mind how they are going to fight these factors.
Fantastic. There were 2 interesting points that you brought up. You mentioned that there is competition in the market, but the quality of work that Talent Corner provides is very, very good. Can you elaborate more in terms of how do you ensure that there is good quality work that is delivered?
The quality of work means if I'm having any requirement, like, and if I'm sending 4 CVs to the client, and out of that 4, if client is saying okay, 2 are totally relevant to me, we can go ahead with the interview. That is the quality of work in my terms. If we send 15 CV and only 2 or 4 are shortlisted, then we are just sending the CVs, building their database.
Correct. So means that sending good and relevant profiles to the client
good
is important.
Yeah, good screening should be done at our end. Whatever the client is requiring, if there is some mismatch or something, is that should be already discussed with the HR. Okay, you are asking for this thing, but we are having this kind of CVs as well. If they would like to go with that, then we send.
Okay.
It's not blindly, well, okay, they have asked for XYZ thing and we started sending them.
And you have built this rapport with the client that you are directly having a conversation with them and they're giving you inputs in terms of what they're looking for and what they're not looking for. Is that understanding right?
Yes.
Right. Great. Also, you mentioned that you've built a team, you know, while in the Talent Corner franchise model, it is not compulsory to build a team or it's not compulsory to even build an office. What, according to you, have been the advantages A, of building a team, and B, of building your own office?
Well, as I said, I worked a long time in a corporate, so I have always worked with a team. Like 15-20 team is there, I have read them, or things have been in that way. So that was always a quality in me that I would like to have a team. And if I wanted to do an individual basis, then I could have straight away go with those companies or jumped into another company if I am not happy with the current one. But starting my own on office, on franchisee, we have invested having an office. Then my aim was to have a team where we can do the recruitment for more and more companies.
Right. And have you been able to, you know, build a good team for yourself? And has there been any challenges that someone should be aware about while they're building a team?
Touch wood, till now, whatever team I have, having was good enough to work well, although I was training them time to time, but they were capable of doing the work. So that's the main thing. And I would like to suggest, when I work, when we select team, their stability we should check, their willingness to work. Because if that person is not having the zest to work to achieve something, you cannot help them. If they cannot help themselves, they cannot help us.
Great, great. Also, while we spoke about challenges, with your day-to-day routine,
mm-hmm.
do you see that these are the great opportunities that recruitment industry has for us to look forward to? What are these opportunities that you can think of?
I think there are a lot of opportunities. Sky is the only limit, I can say. Because if you just open the LinkedIn, there's a lot of people are looking for a job. It's just finding the right person, putting them in the right company, and that is our job actually.
Right. Do you see yourself potentially rising from here into building a bigger team? Do you see your profits going higher?
Well, I cannot comment much on the profit side because I'm just on the growing part. So first, my concentration was to build a good team, stable team, experienced team. And that, in that terms, I have succeeded in this 1 year span of this office. Yeah, and the profit side will definitely move on.
Great. One of the most important things that gets spoken about in the franchisee world,
mm-hmm.
is about transparency, right? And I think good brands are the ones which actually maintain complete transparency, whether it's about operational process or whether it's about financial process. What has been your experience with Talent Corner in both these aspects? Are they very transparent when it comes to operational process? Are they very transparent in terms of financial process?
I must appreciate Talent Corner in this subject, because whatever has been committed on the first day about the financial thing, about the support thing, that still now we have getting all the support. And no challenges in the financial part. whatever is committed, whatever ratio was committed, it's like that only, and very simple calculation. It's not very complex calculation that I have to put how to, I should calculate what will be my ratio or what, how I'm going to get and how the follow-ups will be the client, with the client will be done for the financial part. So that is very crystal clear.
And on the operational front, are you kept in loop with all communication with the client? Are you aware about what's being signed up? Do you have all information before you take on a client?
Yes, that information is already shared. What is the charge to the client? What is the credit period? When they are going to clear the bill? Everything is shared. Even the agreement copy is also shared with us.
Fantastic. And how do you see this relationship with Talent Corner getting built up over the next few years?
Well, as I said, I have left a very well-reputed job, started an office, started with a team, so definitely I am planning to go more years with the Talent Corner. There is no question about that.
Great. Seema, thank you so much for being with us today.
My pleasure.
And really wishing you all the best. We hope that this venture with you grows and leaves a lasting mark for everybody in the industry. Thank you.
Definitely. And with your support, it's definitely going to happen.
Thank you so much.
Pleasure.